Hey, this is Teresa with the key to be free. So are you ready for some battle notes amidst your circumstances that you're going through? All right, get ready and open up your Bibles to Isaiah chapter 7, verses 1 through 7. Now, in this particular bit of scripture, it has to do with a wicked king, King Ahaz, and the tribe of Judah. He wasn't trusting God, wasn't following God, and he came up against two enemies. Yeah, two enemies that pretty much wanted to take him out and destroy him. And word got around to Ahaz's court, the royal throne of David, and it said they were so scared, they were so fearful, it said that they were moved as the trees of the wind are moved with the wind. Needless to say, they were scared spitless. But the Lord has a specific word for Isaiah to speak to Ahaz and the people here. It's a powerful word that no matter what you're going through, no matter the wind and the fierce fire that you're going through, it's a word for you too. It's a word for me. Check it out. Verse 4. This is the Lord telling Isaiah to say to the people, "Take heed and be quiet. Do not fear or be faint-hearted for these two stubs of smoking firebrands, for the fierce anger of Rezin and Syria. Take heed and be quiet." That's part one. Take heed means to be calm, to take notice, and be quiet. I love this one, be quiet. So often our tongue, we start talking about our problems, and the next thing you know, our problems are overtaking us because we keep talking about them. It says in Proverbs that there's the power of life and death in our tongue. So there's a reason here why the Lord is telling Ahaz and his people to be quiet. Basically, stop talking about the problem and trust me. And then, of course, the powerful point of do not fear. Nothing paralyzes your faith more than when you walk in fear. When you walk in fear, you limit God. I know fear has a way of taking you by the neck and wanting to hold you there. But you don't have to walk there. You can strengthen yourself in the Word of God and your faith. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the Word of God. And then the Lord mentions these two stubs, the Lord calls them. They're the enemies, the two enemies that are coming up against Ahaz and the tribe of Judah here in Israel. The Lord has an interesting thing what he calls them. He calls them two stubs. Instead of them being firebrands, which Ahaz thinks something that can cause a fire to destroy, the Lord says they're just two smoldering stubs. Something that is not powerful, it's not going to catch you on fire. God promises to have Judah as his remnant that would always be faithful to secure God's messianic promises to Abraham. God's faithful to his word. Judah was not going to be destroyed by these two stubs. And then the final word, you got to underline this. Verse 7, "Thus says the Lord God, it shall not stand, nor shall it come to pass." So as you battle something that wants to take you and grip you and paralyze you by fear, apply these scriptures. Apply to God. Take heed. Be quiet. Go do something. Those enemy is a smoldering enemy. And take to heart the word of God. It shall not stand, nor shall it come to pass. So I encourage you to look beyond your circumstances and to keep dreaming. Jesse the Planist, I love this, I'll end it with this. To dream of whatever you're dreaming of, be out of debt, healing for your body, your marriage to be together, your family to be together. To dream is not the phantoms of our brain, but the outline of our divine destiny. You're destined to be free. Take those steps. Take heed. Be calm. Get yourself in the Word. Hold on to the Word, no matter what's coming at you. And I know you will be free. Jesus came to give us life and life abundantly. And I know you're ready to walk in that abundant life. Hey, this is Teresa with the key to be free. I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.